Flower dissection. After completing this video, you should be able to 1. Name the parts and structures of flowers, including petals and sepals. 2. Differentiate a monocot from a dicot. And 3. Demonstrate the correct procedure for dissecting flowers. To complete this lab, you'll need the following materials: personal protective equipment, dissection tools and pan, 3 flower specimens that you've collected, cut the flower with 1 or 2 inches of stem remaining, and a camera for documenting your work. You'll need 3 different types of flowers to complete this lab. Your flowers may look different than the ones in this video, but they'll have the same parts. First, pull off the sepals of each flower and count how many there are. Keep the parts of each flower separate. Set the sepals of each flower aside to be presented with your dissection pictures. Next, do the same for the petals. Again, set these aside, keeping the petals of each flower separate. Notice the male part of the flower, the stamen. It includes the anther and filament. Observe the female part of the flower, the carpel. The carpel consists of the stigma, style, and ovary. With a scalpel or sharp knife, carefully cut the ovary in half. Attempt to squeeze out the ovules. These can be viewed with the naked eye or under the magnifier included in your dissection kit. While you may not have access to a microscope, it's also possible to make a slide of pollen for viewing under a compound microscope. This can be done by placing a drop of water onto a slide and dabbing the anthers of a flower into the water droplet several times. The pollen grains are best viewed under low light and should appear as uniform, circular structures. For each flower, lay out all of the floral structures and label them. Take a picture of the labeled structures and submit it with your laboratory report. Include a table that indicates the number of sepals and petals for each of the 3 flowers you dissect. Also indicate whether the flower comes from a monocot or dicot. See the instructions located in the learning unit associated with this lab for additional details on submitting this lab.